Hello everyone, myself Dr. M.SRUJAN Kumar. My education background is pharmacy. Today's topic is introduction and classification of polymers. These polymers play an important role in our day-to-day life. Especially in the case of pharmaceutical industries, these polymers have wide applications. The first application is it helps in the manufacturing of catheters, it helps in the manufacturing of syringes, it helps in the manufacturing of formulations, etc. Okay, so what do you mean by the term polymers? Polymer is derived from the Greek word poly, that means many, and meros means parts. It is derived from the two Greek words poly, many, and meros, parts. Okay, so how do you define polymers? Polymers are long chain molecules assembled from small molecules called as monomers. In order to define in a different way, many number of monomer units joined together to form a large molecule called as polymers. Directly we move on to the classification of polymers. So the polymers are classified into five types. First one, based upon origin of source. Based upon the origin of source, it is classified into three types again: natural, semi-synthetic, and synthetic. What are the examples for polymers originated from natural source? Cellulose, starch, etc. Semi-synthetic, example, cellulose derivatives. For this, example, cellulose acetate, etc. Okay, example for semi-synthetic, nylon, comma, poly, esters, etc. What are the examples? Any polymer that has been originated from natural source, from natural origin. The examples are your cellulose, starch, etc. From semi-synthetic, cellulose derivatives, cellulose acetate, etc. Synthetic, nylon, polyesters, etc. Okay, this is the first type of classification based upon origin of source. Now the second one is based upon structure. Based upon the structure, it is divided into three types. One is linear chain polymer. Next, branch chain polymer. Next, cross link polymer. Now, what do you mean by linear chain? Linear chain is nothing but it has repeating units of monomers arranged in a straight line. Repeating units of monomers arranged in a straight line. This is nothing but linear. Okay? The example for your linear chain molecules are PVC, polyvinyl chloride. Next, what do you mean by branched chain? Linear chain molecules containing branches is called as branched chain polymers. Examples are low density polymers. Next, cross-linked polymer. What are these cross-linked polymers? Polymers prepared from bifunctional and trifunctional monomers with strong covalent bond are called as cross-linked polymers. I repeat, polymers prepared from bifunctional and trifunctional monomers having strong covalent bond are called as cross-linked polymers. Okay, example is melamine. What is the example? Melamine. This is the second type of classification. Next, We'll move on to third type of classification based upon mode of polymerization. Based upon mode of polymerization, it is again divided into two: addition and condensation. Addition and condensation. The examples for addition type polymers are ethylene converted to polyethylene. This is an addition type. What do you mean by condensation type of polymers? The condensation reaction will take place between bifunctional and trifunctional polymers, which results in the formation of condensation type polymer. The example will be your nylon. Nylon is an example for condensation polymer. Now, based upon molecular mass, it's again divided into four types. The first one, elastomers. Next, fibers. Next, thermoplastic. Next, thermosetting. What are elastomers? Elastomers are the polymers having viscoelasticity with weak intermolecular forces. What are elastomers? Elastomers are the polymers having viscoelasticity with weak intermolecular forces. The examples for your elastomers are rubbers. Next, fibers. These are the polymers obtained from fibers. Okay, fiber is the source where the polymer is obtained. So, example is cellulose fibers. Next, what do you mean by thermoplastic? On heating, it will get liquefied. What do you mean by thermoplastic? On heating, it will get liquefied. On cooling, it will get hardened. It is called as thermoplastic. The examples for your thermoplastic is PVC. As I told, PVC is nothing but polyvinyl chloride. What do you mean by thermosetting type of polymer? Thermosetting type of polymers are the polymers which are having irreversible hardening reaction. That means that when you, with the aid of heating, you need to heat it to a suitable shape. Okay, and what do you mean by thermosetting? It is nothing but irreversible hardening of your polymer. Okay, so the example for your thermosetting is bakelite. What is thermosetting? Just you need to keep your polymer in a mold and you need to go for heating. After heating, you need to leave it for some time so that it will get hardened. On heating, it will get hardened. That is nothing but called as thermosetting. This is an irreversible reaction. This is thermoplastic, is a reversible reaction. Okay. First, it will get converted into liquid in the case of thermoplastic. Again, it will be hardened and come back to its original position. That is thermoplastic. That's the difference between a thermoplastic and thermosetting. Now, next classification based upon biostability. Based upon biostability. It is divided into two: biodegradable polymers . These are nothing but decompose . Next classification based upon biostability. Biostability. It is divided into two types: biodegradable polymers and non-biodegradable polymers. Examples for your biodegradable polymers are proteins, carbohydrates, etc. The example for your non-biodegradable polymers are HPMC, silicones, ethyl, cellulose, etc. Okay, this is the fifth type of classification of your polymers. Thank you very much for watching. In the next class, we will meet up with the individual applications of polymers in novel drug delivery systems. Thank you very much. Please subscribe to my channel. Thank you.